Good evening and praise the Lord. I welcome the Mushai's family in today's service. Thank you so much for another opportunity that you have given me and that you have acknowledged me to be your home pastor. It is an honor. I want to appreciate my son Calvin for allowing me to do this recording so that I may send you this recording so that during the time of sermon, you will also present it. It's an honor. I am humbled. May the Lord continue to bless you. It has not been an easy year for all of us, but in all, we want to thank God because God has been very gracious and very faithful in our lives. Let us pray. Father, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we come before your presence as we are about to hear your word. May you speak to us. May you encourage us. May you, God Almighty, remind us that you love us with an everlasting love. Be with us, and this is a prayer of faith. In Jesus' name, we pray and give thanks. Amen. I want to share the word of God from the book of Exodus, chapter 33, verse 14, where God told Moses that my presence will go with you and I will give you rest. I know when you get time, you'll read the whole chapter and you'll be able to understand what was happening and now to where we are. My theme today is that it's not all wilderness that is meant to destroy us or to kill us. God take us into wilderness with a reason and with a purpose. So some of you might be entering into some wilderness. Others might be walking over in the wilderness. And even others are about to get out from the wilderness. It all depends on the phase that you are. But one thing is that not all wilderness are there to finish us or to destroy us. We want to reflect on the children of Israelites. The Bible tells us that the journey that we are going to the promised land, it was supposed to take only 11 days. But we don't know why God took the children of Israelites for 40 years in the wilderness. And one thing I was thinking when I was taught to share the word of God by Calvin, this is a word that came in my mind, that God wanted to reveal himself in the wilderness to the children of Israel. Until we go to the wilderness, it is when we'll be able to understand the will and the purpose of God in our lives. It has not been an easy journey for the children of Israel. God took them into the wilderness so that they may be able to understand that there is God who provide even when we are in the wilderness, so that they may also be able to understand the power and the mighty hand of God, so that they also may be able to appreciate the presence and the existence of God who took them in the wilderness. Yet they suffered, they had other issues they were going through, but God was there for them. And during this chapter that we have read, we see very well that the children of Israelites were telling Moses, Moses was telling God that he was pleading. Moses was standing in the gap, pleading on behalf of the children of Israelites, because God had told Moses, go to the promised land, na mtafika, and everything will be good. But Moses decided to tell God, God, no, it is not about us going to promised land. It is about you, God, going together with us. But God had told them, I will not go with you. One, you people, you are stiff-necked people. And when I was thinking about that word, stiff-necked people, when your neck is stiff, you are not able to turn back. And God wanted to tell them, you should look where I took you from. You should reflect the journey that we have walked together. You should look back, all of us, where God has taken us. And as we are about to celebrate Christmas and everything, and as we come to the end of this year, may the Lord help us not to be stiff-necked people. May the Lord help us to turn back and to look and to reflect our journey. It was not an easy journey, but God has seen us through. We want to thank God for the fact that he has brought us. God wanted them to remember his mighty hand there in Egypt, the way God has walked with them, the way now they have forgotten that it is about God. May the Lord help us never to forget that where we are, all the blessings that we have, that all the achievement that we have acquired as the Moshais, it is not about our effort, it is all about God. Number two, God was telling them, I'll not go with you because when I go with you, I'll finish you. God requires a repentive heart. I thank God because of Moses, who stood in the gap and told God, Father, you have to go with us. If you're not going with us, we'll not even make any move. But I thank God because God heard the prayers of Moses. And he told Moses, my presence will go with you. When we are in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy. When we are in the presence of the Lord, there is that inner peace. Even if things are not going the way we would like them to be, but there is that the inner peace that be calm. I am God. I am with you. Remember the disciples of Jesus when they were going on the other side to preach the word of God and the storm were raging, but Jesus was still in that boat. Remember that story? When the presence of God is with us, he's able to calm every storm. And how I pray, dear brothers and sisters, our sons, the fourth generation, the second and the first generation, how I pray for the Moshai's family, may we never forget that in every wilderness, God will be together with us. Not all wilderness is there to destroy us. Others are there to encourage our heart and to give us the spirit of keep on going. When the journey is not easy, God is calling us to keep on pressing on, remembering that he is our God, our Alpha and Omega. He will never leave us nor forsake us. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. Remember, as we come to the end of a year, we have a reason to tell God, thank you. You have been with us in that wilderness of COVID. You're still with us even now, and we'll continue glorifying your holy name. Do not give up. Do not tire. Let us keep close walk with God. Let us align ourselves to the purposes of God. Let us understand God in our lives. How I pray for you, that may the Lord renew your strength as we come to the end of this year, giving thanks that God of wilderness has seen us through, and he'll continue seeing us through. When we look back, he will never let us fall. He will never let us fail. He will always be our guide and our help. In the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Shall we pray? Almighty and everlasting Lord, I want to thank you for the Moshai's family. I thank you even for reminding us that in this wilderness that we have been going through, others have gone through the wilderness and they are out of the wilderness and they have a reason to thank you. How we pray that even now you will continue walking with us, because not all wilderness are there to destroy us. Others are there to affirm us and to make our hearts strong and to rely on you and to help us to seek your will and also your purposes in this wilderness. How we pray, dear Father, as we come to the end of this year, continue blessing the first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, and even other generation that will come in Moshai his family. Bind them together with a cord that can never be broken. May you always be their God and their Father. We want to thank you because this year we have buried one of us, but Father, you have been together with us. Continue comforting us, continue encouraging us, continue lifting us up and higher. Above every other thing, we call upon your name that you may help us to align to your will and also to your purposes. More to it, help us to love you, to seek you, and to call upon your holy name. Help us to stand strong and to be united in one accord, whether we are near or far. God Almighty, this distance does not matter, because God, you are everywhere, our omnipresent. And this is a prayer of faith. In Jesus' name we pray and we give thanks. Amen. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. We are looking forward to many blessings coming here. I wish you a Merry Christmas and also a Happy New Year. For those who are not married, I predict and I prophesy that next year we'll have many weddings and many will get married, and we thank God for that. May the Lord bless you. Thank you so much, the family of Moshai. Thank you so much, my son Calvin. You've been following this and I love your passion. Be blessed and God do you well. Thank you, thank you. Receive our greetings from the Rees. Who was preaching? The one who was preaching to you is none other than home pastor, Reverend Mary Rie. God bless you.